On a game two of this series, my computer exploded before we were able to finish game one, so I don't actually know what the victory point count was, and I hope the YouTube video is not corrupted, but maybe that will be one of the lost episodes. Game two of the series, I know Loveness definitely won game one, and he did so with probably roughly 300 some victory points left.
Conscripts at our disposal.
So here in game two, Leveness is going to be playing as Soviets against Captain Price's Oster, Guard Motor Shock Rifle, and
This
Tank
is
Hunter
our
Tactics.
sector now.
Or no, Lend-Lease. Versus Jaeger Armor, German Mechanized and Jaeger Infantry. So Captain Price has a very non-meta loadout, and I've seen him running this loadout in the past. I have. This is, I think, Captain Price's attempt at Coco Jambo, rear echelon spam in game one. This loadout in game two with a sniper
Sniper
opening.
here.
Pretty edgy stuff so far, of course, has not worked.
We have a fresh grenadier squad.
Which is a pretty important criteria to keep in mind. But let's see if he has more success this game than he did in game one. Loveness going with a three conscript opening, slowly working his way through the south and center. Sniper gets an opening shot right there. Will reveal itself. Loveness has conscripts. Loveness is going to react to that by going tier 1, I assume. Just queued up a second combat engineer, so I expect him to build tier 1 on the base for a scout car to try and hunt this thing down. So far, Sniper's doing an excellent job of bleeding Loveness manpower. It's gotten two kills already. Misses that shot on the church, but if Price just keeps that thing firing at all times, we get an excellent return on investment. Pressured out of his cover position by these advancing conscripts. Sniper will advance aggressively toward them. Can't quite get a line.
Our opponents are seizing the
And
sector.
Price has set up his infamous trap here by the building. Loveness clearly not taking the bait. The way he's placed the wire on these doors means that a unit could probably get in the house but not leave. And getting the wire just right for that is pretty hard, actually. But Price seems to be pretty practiced at that. This might work. I almost want to see somebody jump in that house just to see if it'll if they'll get trapped. Ooh, that volley! That was terrible. Loveness is gonna follow up on that with Urok. Get in the camo! Oh, that sniper is so dead. Oh, he keeps camoing just in time. Because they were ooh-rawing, they couldn't fire while sprinting. If he had just maybe just walked toward the sniper, who knows what might have happened. That volley brought that sniper so close. But he managed to get it to safety this time. There's the M3. Flamethrower jumping inside will be an extremely serious threat to the sniper.
He's dead. Taking small arms fire. They are killing us. We're losing them.
Combat engineers will win. Pyos, I think, charging them over open ground are gonna. Okay, never mind. Loveness retreats from that engagement. It looked like he'd won it to me. Here comes the M3. Grenadiers are protecting. Loveness will kite for now. Sniper was taking shots against this squad, forced to move back to safety. Still no healing for Price yet, but it's upgrading in his base. Once you can get that sniper healed, which he will go do now rather than risking any further engagements, it'll be in a much safer position, but the flamethrower M3 is doing heavy damage to grenadiers in this building. Conscripts moving up to take control of the munitions. Price has to be very careful here. Some squads falling quite low. That one's got a retreat. Fresh one arrives to support in this engagement. They'll set up in green cover. Still going down very quickly though. Flamethrower jumps into the building outside of the M3. The squad in flamethrower range will not be able to stick around, and there's the retreat. Loveness takes full control of this area, throwing green cover position up on the fuel point as well, and the sniper has not been firing for a while. It's up to 8 kills in 5.5 minutes, which is okay. That's not really that impressive. He's been forced to retreat probably one too many times. And that's why he's losing total control of this game. Currently, triple caps, has no fuel point. Not a good situation to be in. And he doesn't really have a solution to the M3 either. And it looks like Loveness is going to go with two M3s, Paul style. M3 goes down to double Faust. Flamethrower there is forced retreat. Second flamethrower on the field will secure the church, however. Start dealing damage to these grenadiers. Sniper arrives to support in the engagement, though. With the first M3 destroyed, the sniper has a little bit of room to breathe. The second one, of course, is going to be on the field soon. Price may not be expecting it. And Loveness may be able to take advantage of that, but picking up that M3 might actually help Price come back into the game a little bit, taking control of the south cutoff here. Grenadiers taking control of the center VP. Trying to slow down Loveness' economy while he works on getting the north back under his control. Forcing a few retreats. Loveness currently only has 5 combat capable squads out to Price's 4 plus sniper plus machine gun coming, so I think Price should be able to transform that pickup into some map control. Depending on how this scout car does. It did reveal itself to those grenadiers right there. So Price knows about it. No real shock value or surprise. Element of surprise for this M3. It's actually taking quite a bit of damage just from grenadier small arms fire, so it's gonna have to pull back for some repairs. After, I think, pushing away these Pios here in the south. Going in on these Pios would be a little bit dangerous, I think, but Price almost never plants an early teller mine. I don't think I've ever seen him do that, so Loveness is not particularly worried. We'll easily force that retreat. Might lose the M3 with these grenadiers, though. It's falling dangerously low to MP40s from the Pios, actually. Bring the M3 down to almost just a quarter of HP left, but it looks like it's going to get to safety. Grenadiers set up in green cover here, probably lose against conscripts oorawing into short range. Going down very fast. There's the retreat. Yeah.
Pioneers ready for anything. Pioneers ready for anything. You want something?
And now a T-70 is in production for Love Nest. Price only just now getting battle phase one, which is a little bit late. T-70 is going to have a pretty real shock value. This is now keeping the sniper alive against an M3 is one thing. Keeping it alive against T-70 is another. And he's probably going to need an AT gun. He needs to get it out pretty fast. He's gone with 4 Grens, 2 Pios, sniper, MG42. So very big investment. Big investment into Oster Tier 1. Which is going to leave him a little bit weak against this. Making its way to the front line now. The sniper is currently exposed. Panzerfaust, however, will connect with the M3, and it looks like that's going to be destroyed before Loveness T-70 can prevent it. Getting into the engagement now, and Price will disengage. He has no choice. Minesweeper and other Pio squad also retreating. Meanwhile, the sniper moves up to take shots here in the north. T-70 is looking for wipe opportunities, I think, so the sniper might get to take a few more shots. T-70 has not received engine damage yet and will continue diving Pios straight into the base. If he picks up both squads of Pios, that will mean no tier 2 structure. This could be GG because this is happening. Oh no. Is that destroyed engine? That is destroyed engine. Trice has no choice but to queue up a fresh squad of Pios. He cannot build tier 2 because he doesn't have any Pios on the field, which leaves me the only way he has of killing this is with Panzerfaust spam, which is a dangerous thing to do. He did get a lucky destroyed engine crit on the T-70, which will slowly try and backpedal out of the base. The M3 is pulling back for repairs in the Soviet base, so that'll be pretty much fine. Sniper has forced all infantry here in the north to retreat, except for one wounded squad of conscripts working on the VP, and Price is just going to try to avoid the T-70 for now and work on getting control of his center victory point. Demo charge on the church. Sniper working on this flamethrower.
Enemy forces are attempting to capture our territory.
Dangerous engagement for all parties involved. Flamethrower will retreat first. Grenadier is working on the south, and the T-70 continues slowly pulling back to safety. The fresh Pios are on the field and have built the tier 2. Finally, Price will have access to the PAC-40.
This sector is secured. Capture complete.
M3 is repaired, making his way towards the north. Pio's capturing this territory. Grenadier's on their way towards the south. And guards have been fielded by Loveness, who has gone guard motor coordination, takes up a position inside of the church.
The PEC gun is ready for orders.
Full retreat from the north. The flamethrower is a little too scary. Conscripts trying to find an opportunity on that sniper, but they don't get there quite in time, and this T-70 is going to receive repairs against all odds. There's the AT gun. I honestly think that engine destroyed crit might be the only reason Price is even still in this game. If Loveness had just stayed in the base with the T-70 though, he probably could have prevented the tier 2 from ever going up. Who knows what might have happened. He also could have lost his T-70, so.
The enemy has broken our supply lines. The enemy is attempting to steal our sector.
Conscript set up in green cover right here. AT gun setting up, fires at the T-70 right there. That's gonna pull back to safety.
The hard part will be keeping it.
The mortar team has arrived.
Replenished.
Loveness will continue taking control of the map everywhere. Price very boxed into his base. Sniper currently has 22 kills in 14 minutes, which is like actually not that bad. Not bad at all. But
enemy forces are securing our territory.
Thank you, Noob Power.
Pioneer squad back here.
For your $3 donation. Thank you for supporting the stream. Much appreciated. Minesweeper cleans up the mine here on the cutoff. Ooh-hoo! That AT gun shot so close. M3 gets away by a sliver right there. A lot of bleed on Price here though. Swept up one mine, but the heavy mortar nailed him. Ooh, that was close. T-70, I think, is looking for an opportunity against the sniper now, and the AT gun is set up to protect. Here in the south, MG-42 is going to start working on the conscripts right here. AT gun has to pull back away from some conscripts there in the middle. And Loveness is just working his way towards Collins, which he's definitely going to be able to put a lot of pressure on Price once those arrive. Price does have two AT guns out already to protect against the first wave. And he himself has chosen German mechanized, so he's probably going to go command tank soon. I don't know if he's going to have that much success in breaking out of his base, even with a command tank. Of course, Loveness has not yet gone tier 2, so he doesn't have any access to AT guns yet, meaning a command tank actually will be a semi-significant threat. No AT grenades researched yet either. Guards will help manage that threat, which he does have one squad of guards, and he's also got a lot of defenses planted at various locations. Heavy mortar bleeding Price's manpower and team weapons, a demo charge on the church, mines all over the north.
We are down to 200 points.
So any advance that Price tries to make, actually on pretty much any front, looks like it will be very costly. He has to be very slow and steady to get territory back under his control. He is doing the right thing, sending a minesweeper with his grenadiers to get this territory, but he spots a T-70 right there, so that's not going to happen. More mines there, there, on the road, on the VP. Here comes the command tank. Oh, that grenade! Oh my god. For a second, I dared to dream. Command tank pulling towards the center to try and push away some conscripts. Bringing them down pretty quickly. The T-70 receiving repairs over here on the right, and grenadiers are working on munitions and fuel. MG42 working on the center. Command tank drives right over that demo charge. Loveness didn't think that was worth it though. It wouldn't kill it. It would just maybe like half its HP roughly. Maybe not even that. Grenadiers will probably win this engagement against a minesweeper. Wounded conscripts will secure the building, however. T-70 rolling up towards the middle to assist. Did something just get wiped right there? I'm not sure what it was. Conscript squad, maybe. Full conscript squad just went down. I think that might have been the first wipe for Loveness of the entire game, now that I'm thinking about it. Yeah, that's the only squad that he's lost. One squad of conscripts right there. Meanwhile, Price has lost tons of stuff. As you can see, two grins, two pios. Pretty expensive early game for Price. Coming back into it is proving difficult. 35 kills on his sniper is probably the only reason this game is still somewhat possible. Third AT gun in production, further preparation for the T-34-85s. Heavy mortar gets a big hit on the machine gun right there. That's got to pull back to safety. Guards leave the church, which is taking too much damage to utilize as a defensive position. T-70 will continue working on the north. Grenadiers have a shot blocker here, so that helps a little bit. AT grenade on the command tank, and that's going to have to pull back for some repairs to its engine. Minesweeper pios are very nearby. Be able to get that repaired soon. Enemy contact. We get better every day. This is Tremors, enemy armor. T-70 will scare off those grenadiers to hit it with a Panzerfaust, so it also needs to pull back for some repairs, but it also has combat engineers very nearby. Price currently has one victory point, one fuel point, and other than that, basically nothing. Clock is ticking. He's running out of time. Even with only two VPs, Loveness will probably win this game, and the T-34s are only going to apply additional pressure. And Loveness is actually waiting a while to field them. Spending manpower on guard. Wait, his guards got wiped? What happened? Didn't realize his guards died. That's actually a big pickup for Price. missed whatever that was. I wonder if the command tank picked them up. Has 15 kills. Conscripts Urawing in on the sniper. Big volley right there. Oh, cross red cover. There's the snipe. Conscripts finish the job and the sniper goes down. Command tank didn't land a single decent shot against that squad during that. Sniper pays the price in blood. That sniper had 30-some kills. That is a painful time to be losing that, right with the arrival of the T-34s rolling onto the field. The sniper is dead. The T-70 and even the M3 with the flamethrower inside is still a threat. Command tank is going to rotate south, try and clean that up, and the T-34s are on their way to retaliate, I think. Big push by Price for the middle with most of his infantry and team weapons. AT guns are set up for that T-34. They land a shot, so Price knows that they have arrived. Command tank is going to rotate back up towards the middle as well. Two AT guns supporting the command tank, third one here by the building. And Price is moving to try and get back control of his cutoff right here. All three T-34s take shots, or all three AT guns take shots at the T-34 right there, bringing it extremely low. Grenadiers have to pull back away from the T-70, and Loveness will just continue working the flanks of the map, knowing that Price doesn't have very much pushing power with just team weapons. Heard a demo charge. Oh, nice sweep. Minesweeper picks up a demo charge on the munitions. Command tank is going to rotate north with one AT gun supporting. Try and get rid of this T-70. Try and get another victory point under control. The minesweeper's here, so it will help clear up some of these threats on the road. Heavy mortar bleeding him along the way. Conscripts trying to prevent that mine sweep. Will force the retreat. That means he can't clean up any of these other mines. One in the road, one on this approach. I think he spotted both of them though, so that knowledge will at least help him.
We are losing a sector.
Flamethrower taking control of the VP here in the middle. These two squads of Grenadiers are pulling back to safety. T-34 looks like it might have an opportunity against the command tank right there. Two AT guns are set up against it though. Takes a big volley of damage right there. The other T-34 has been fully repaired and is making its way back to the battlefield. AT grenade from Conscripts. Oh no. Engine destroyed. I don't know if Price is going to be able to get that repaired before something shows up to just kill him. Like this T-34 for example. There's a lot of AT guns available to protect right here, but I don't think that they're going to be able to do enough damage in time. There it goes, command tank destroyed, and T-34 does go down in exchange, so that's something. AT guns all managed to get a line right there. But it may not matter, I don't think Price could afford the loss of that command tank against Guard Motor. This T-34 is going to pull back into the base, needs to get repaired. The other one's been destroyed, but other than that, the clock is still ticking against Price. With only 47 points left, he doesn't show any signs of being able to get territory back. This M3 flamethrower is probably just going to shove these bios back into the base. AT gun did come along for the engagement, might get a line. Hedge is blocking. Grenadiers on their way. Flamethrower got out of the vehicle so that if it were to get destroyed, it would be alright. Firing through the hedge, she will destroy its engine. Small arms fire will probably finish the job. There it goes.
We have a new Panzer IV. Enemies
there! LMG Grenadiers convinced that flamethrower squad to retreat, and here comes the triple cap attempt from Loveness to try and finish out the game. He deploys smoke with his mortar. You don't see smoke that You don't see Soviet smoke very frequently. It looks like he will at least get the point decapped right here. Speed up the clock against Price a little bit. T-34 is moving to protect in the south. Try and get that minesweeper out of there. Lands one good hit. There's the retreat. Point will not get captured. Clock keeps ticking against Price. Trying to get the point back under control here in the middle. He has fielded a new command tank to help him in that endeavor.
We are close to defeat. 25 points remaining. Specially outfitted Panzer IV command tanks are now available.
Command tank immediately hits a mine. It's going to be destroyed. Smoke bombs being deployed by Price to try and buy time. I don't really think that's going to help though. Everything Price has is on its way to try and perform some sort of rescue operation. Conscripts are about to get the clock ticking against Price again here in the south, despite being under LMG Grand Fire. There's more infantry on the way. The command tank is destroyed in this engagement because it hit that mine, and the T-34 will get away unpunished. And a fresh set of T-34-85s has been fielded. If that's not the game, I don't know what could be. T-34 is just gonna dive the AT gun wall right here. Gets a lucky main gun, destroyed crit. So I don't even know. Alright, that one's dead apparently. I don't think it even matters that one has died though. Still another one in the south, this one right here. Loveness has the clock ticking against Price, who has failed in his attempt to defend the south victory point.
Our opponents are seizing a sector.
Pack loaded for panther hunting.
T-70 and T-34 will prevent harassment of the north victory point. Everything defending the south will prevent harassment of that. And it looks like that's gonna be GG.
We are losing a sector.
One point remaining.
Awaiting orders.
And there you have it. Loveness will take the series. He has defeated his first challenger. Well played, Loveness.